Hi, hello.
and dialed in and connected. Wolfie Van Halen, how are you, man? I love the studio here. It's this is kind of the same shot you used on Stern the other day, yeah?
Yes, this is my studio.
Very cool. Okay, so I gotta ask, do you go by Wolf or Wolfie? What do you prefer?
I go by everything. My growing up, my close friends and family would call me Wolfie, but as I've gone older, I guess people call me more or Wolfgang.
Okay, all right. What kind of mic are you using there, just out of curiosity?
Just a regular old.
Like an SM58.
I have an SM 57 over there.
Okay. Nice, man. Hey, congratulations on the new song Distance. So many of us were such huge fans of your dad, and it's just awesome to see you carrying on that legacy, man.
Thank you.
You played all the instruments on the track. You sang on the track. When touring resumes, or maybe virtual shows or whatever, where do you see yourself? Like behind the mic, with or without a guitar, playing bass? I'm sure you thought all that out, yeah?
Yeah, I'll be playing guitar and singing.
Okay, all right, dynamite, man. Honestly, the world knows fairly little about you. I mean, you and your family have always done such a great job at, kind of being introverted. Aside from music, what's your favorite hobby, man? What do you like to do for fun when you just got unplugged from the studio?
Video games.
Okay, what's your
I just had a PS5 just get here, so I can't wait to plug it
Very
in.
cool. Now, do you do the Twitch thing under an alias?
No, I don't actually. I did get Wolf Van Halen on Twitch, so maybe at some point I'll start streaming, maybe.
Yeah. You had the foresight to think of that. Somebody's better capture this, otherwise somebody will gank it out from underneath you.
Exactly.
Yeah. Are you a meat eater? And if so, if you had to choose, would it be chicken, fish, pork, or steak?
Chicken.
Chicken. Okay.
Chicken.
What's your favorite way to prepare chicken? You like the boneless chicken breast? You like to barbecue that
Yeah,
sucker up?
like straight up grilled boneless chicken breast.
Okay. All
Yeah.
right. I'm a steak eater. My wife was vegetarian and then vegan, and now she, for whatever reason, likes meat, but she only allows me to eat steak like once every 7 or 8 days. So I have to really, kind of plan out and prepare when I'm having the steak.
Nice.
Gavin Newsom, latest warning or whatever conspiracy is that he's going to threaten to put people in jail for large gatherings at Thanksgiving coming up here. What does Thanksgiving, that holiday look like in your world?
It's always super chill and private and introverted. You know, it's just how me and my whole family are.
Yeah, you say private, introverted. Are we talking 5 people, 10 people? I mean, there's a lot of
If anything, it'll just be me and my mom, or like me and my Uncle Patrick and my Aunt Stacy.
Okay. And I know you talk to Uncle Alex quite a bit, like every day, right?
Yeah, we talk every day, every
Now,
morning.
does Alex do his own thing, or has there been like big family gatherings for Christmas or Thanksgiving in the past where Alex and all the families are kind of combined?
Not usually, dinners here and there, but never a large gathering.
Yeah. Anything Uncle Alex has taught you, like one big life lesson over the span of a lifetime, man?
Oh man, I really don't know. Gosh. I can't really think. It just kind of both my father and him just lead by their examples, because they're such pillars in the music community. Just being around them is enough to to try
Yeah.
in some of the greatness.
Right. Being a high school kid and going out on the road with Van Halen, did they give you like was there a boot camp or a list of do's and don'ts? Like, look, kid, we're gonna take you out on this big tour, but you can't do this or avoid these pitfalls or whatever else.
If anything, it was the other way around. I was the one who kind of got them excited about going out again, you know?
Yeah. Very cool. Very cool. Looking back at that time touring with the brothers, what would you say was the biggest highlight of that point in time?
No, just any moment being on stage, just being able to share music together like
Right.
that so much every day on stage was a blessing.
Did you have a favorite city, being able to travel, all across the country and around the world, that you had a chance to explore outside of just being, locked in a tour bus working on homework or whatever, that you went, wow, this is a great city. I'd love to come back here and spend a month.
It's hard to play favorites, home shows were always really fun, because that's when all my friends would show up and everybody I knew. So home
Yeah.
shows are always really special.
Now, obviously, growing up, people knew that you were, Eddie's son. But when you jumped up on stage, was there a different level of respect, or did you sense that people treated you a little differently, or was it just, oh yeah, man, we had
Oh, no,
English class together?
if anything, it was more negative. But I think as time went on, and I proved myself, I think people got the gist of it,
Yeah, I just got through doing an interview with Chris Daughtry about 30 minutes ago, and one of the questions I asked Chris Daughtry was, "Hey, have you heard the new Mammoth WVH?" And he goes, "No, I haven't." And I said, "Well, you gotta watch the video first and have some tissue along with you, but listen to Wolfie's voice here. Has anybody else made the comparison between you and the legendary voice of Chris Daughtry? I mean, I was surprised, man."
Oh, not really. That's a huge honor, man. Thank you.
Absolutely.
Yeah, it's that's amazing.
Did you have to take any vocal lessons, just to get your voice in shape to have the range that you've got on distance?
Not too much. I have a normally high singing voice.
Right.
But I did do lessons just to kind of like before every tour, I would do lessons twice a week just to kind of flex the muscle, if anything, but never to learn anything new, just to kind of get the proper techniques down.
Right. Okay, well, that makes sense, man. Any guess on how many Mammoth WVH songs you've written over the course of the last several years?
Upwards of 20, almost 30, probably.
Okay, so enough for maybe two albums if the producer goes, yeah, these are all
Exactly.
slamming,
If
and
they're all good.
a few B-sides here and there. How many did your dad hear? Did Ed hear? And any idea on what his favorite song was that you put together?
He heard pretty much everything.
Okay.
And an upcoming song on the album called Think It Over was far and above his favorite. He loved all of it, but that one song, which is funny because when people hear it, it's probably one of the poppiest songs on the record, but
Okay.
absolutely his favorite.
Dude, your dad had a great pop sensibility, just as far as melody was concerned. I think that's one of the things that made Van Halen unique is, as soon as Alex would come in with the drums, you knew it was a rock song, but your dad, with coming at things as a pianist, could bring out some of these melodies that are, a lot of rock bands don't capture that, right?
Yeah, no, he had the melody for sure.
Yeah. I
Yeah.
know you're doing a ton of these press interviews. You got to be exhausted, man. I mean, it's like you jumped right into the frying pan, right?
That's
From
exciting, man. The last 24 hours have been a whirlwind. The amount of support. It'd be one thing if everybody was like mean and stuff, but everybody's been so kind and wonderful. It's a pleasure.
By the way, I do follow you on Twitter, and like Stern was saying the other day, just screw the haters. They're going to be out there, right? Some of these people are, like they've got, they're attention whores, right? They've got
it's
nothing better
it's
to do than.
it's it's pretty sad, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It is. It's, you got a huge target on your back, man. I mean, it goes without saying. You come from a legendary pedigree. I'm curious, Wolfie, if you were going to give some props to somebody in this interview here. Who is your favorite rock band on the planet today? Aside from, obviously Van Halen and AC/DC, who I know you and your dad, bonded over the love of AC/DC, which is still a great band.
Yeah, absolutely. There's an Australian band called Carnivool.
Ooh, love Car VOOL, right? Yeah,
Their album Sound Awake is a top 10 album.
okay.
The bass player on that, John Stockman is, oh gosh, the bass tone on that album is just phenomenal. That is one of my favorite albums of all time, for sure.
And speaking of that continent, are you a fan of 12 Foot Ninja?
Oh my God, I was just talking to Stevic the other day. We're buddies. Gosh, I love them. I love their cover they just put out of gosh, the Huey Lewis song is fantastic.
I haven't seen that yet. I gotta check it out.
Stuck With You, I think it is. And gosh, they turned it into their own song. It's phenomenal.
I could see those guys dressing up in costume and doing kind of a Stuck With
Yeah.
You as they're all singing
Oh,
along
the
together.
video is hilarious as well.
Are you a fan of some of the British kind of metalcore? Like Don Brocco is a band that has a lot of melody but a really heavy side. I don't know if you're
Oh,
familiar
I'm
with Don
familiar.
Brocco.
I know the name, but I haven't checked them out.
Okay, I can't. I would send you a text on this thing here, but Don Brocco, you should absolutely check out. I'll send you a tweet, right? I'll just
Yeah, for
tweet at
sure.
you with
Yeah,
Don
we'll.
Brocco. And then Bring Me the Horizon is probably one of the more
Oh, yeah.
well-known. Yeah.
They're badass, for
Yeah,
sure.
they're awesome. Wolfie, I know you got a ton of other interviews and stuff to do. Thank you so much for taking the time out. I can't wait to hear the whole album. Do you have a title, and do you have a timeline on when you might release it to the world?
No title yet, but it'll be out probably spring-ish next year.
Okay. Dynamite, man. Can't wait to hear it. Have a great rest of your day, dude. Love
Thank
you,
you.
and of course, hearts and prayers out to you with the loss of your dad, man.
Thanks so much, man. It was a pleasure. Thanks so
All
much.
right. Take care.